Marley from the Energy Boutique with your energy forecast for Sunday, July 21st. Okay, so welcome to the full moon in Capricorn day. This is our second full moon in Capricorn in Cancer season. We had one usher us in and we have one ushering us out. If you haven't listened to the full moon in Capricorn astro forecast that I put out there as of yet, I'm going to recommend you do so. And of course, I'm also going to recommend that you download the moon guide. This is a very important full moon in Capricorn. I know I say that about every moon event. However, this is the final hurrah. It's taking place at 29 degrees in Capricorn energy, which is the most karmic, most critical, most intense degree that you could ever have any event taking place in. This is the clean sweep. This is the ending and the closure that we've been waiting for a very long time. And whatever pops off under this particular full moon is what we are going to be working on cleaning up from now until the fall. So of course, not only is this the full moon in Capricorn, but this is also the last day of Cancer season. We will be moving into Leo season here on the 22nd. And so this is a very, very intense kind of day. Not only are we having this full moon at a 29th degree, we're going to have a lot of interactions as the moon hits this 29th degree and continues onward into that Leo energy. The moon in this Capricorn energy going to hit its peak at 6:18 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And of course, we will see the moon go void, of course, at 7:28 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're locking into Aquarius energy at 7:44 a.m. So typically speaking, even if this wasn't a full moon, the transition from Capricorn energy to Aquarius energy is always a welcomed one. Of course, things are low and slow and semi-serious in Capricorn energy. We should be illuminated to the problems, to the blockages, to the obstacles that we're currently facing. The Aquarius energy is going to help us act as the observer. We get to detach emotionally so that we can see things from a bigger, broader perspective. And the Aquarius energy helps us to think outside of the box, to come up with some creative solutions to some of the problems, some of the obstacles, some of the challenges that we are definitely being illuminated to under that Capricorn influence. So there's definitely going to be a lot thrown at us here today as far as energy goes. We are in the thick of it. We are in this energetic storm. There are 14 different aspects popping off here today, and 10 of them are going to involve the moon. Okay, so the moon in Capricorn energy going to make a very tough interaction with Mercury. Mercury, of course, rules over the mental plane, rules over information, communication, how it is that we express ourselves. He's in his pre-retrograde shadow period, so we're already starting to see some glitches with technology, glitches with communication, with our headspace, with our thoughts, with our ideas. Mercury is in Leo energy, the heart and soul of the zodiac. We have some pretty big ideas kind of percolating within us, some big thoughts, some big, let's call them emotions, that we definitely are going to be illuminated to, that we're definitely going to be realizing as the day progresses here. So the moon is our heart space, Mercury is our head space, and they're not getting along. Likely because Mercury, of course, in this Leo energy has us focused on what it is that we want to do, what we want to pursue, what we want to actually take action and make moves upon. While the moon in Capricorn is focused on the to-do list of what we have to clean up as far as loose ends and debris goes from the old chapters, the old cycles that, of course, are coming to an end. The moon is then going to trine, beautiful interaction, with Uranus, the Great Awakener, in Taurus energy. So this is some earth on earth action here. And the earth energy is going to make us a little bit grounded, a little bit more anchored, a little bit more present, if you will. We're focused on our physical, materialistic realm. And because this is a trine, we're getting a gentle nudge in the right direction. Now, yeah, we're going to kind of continue doing what we got to do to clean up the debris of the past. However, Uranus is opening us up to new ways of doing it, because we're getting bored with the same old, same old. We're getting bored with the mundane. We're getting bored with having to kind of be heavy and weighted in our thoughts, in our emotions, and having to deal with the endings, the closures that, of course, are not fun. So there's like a different glimmer, a different vision, a different dream being kind of delivered to us at this particular point in time. And we're being downloaded with new information, a new level of awareness on where it is that we could spice the old up to make it a little bit tolerable before we can actually get started in building towards the new. The moon is then going to make a positive interaction with that north node in Aries energy. So the north node is trying to get us on the right path to our soul's mission, to our soul's potential, to the next chapter, if you will. The moon in Capricorn energy giving us a logical, practical plan, a logical, practical path on what we have to do to close the door on the past and start advancing our ways towards new goals, new visions, new dreams. We see the growth that we are currently kind of undergoing. We see the opportunity for us to kind of expand in our lives. And we're also starting to see a little bit of potential where new goals, new visions, new dreams are actually becoming a little bit more clear. The moon is then going to make an awkward interaction with Jupiter. Jupiter is the planet of growth, expansion, beliefs, abundance, and blessings. Basically, wisdom that we've plucked out of the tough love life lessons. Jupiter is in Gemini energy, really putting a lot of pressure on our mental plane to choose, to decide between different paths, different directions, different options. We're very divided in that particular energy at this present moment. The moon interacting with Jupiter is going to be a little bit of a Debbie Downer. We're not feeling as hot, as confident, as capable as we would like. Normally, there is a level of optimism and confidence that comes with Mr. Jupiter, but we're just not feeling that great as of right now. A little bit of a Debbie Downer situation, a little bit of a negative Nancy situation, but there's a good reason for that. We are just hours away from the full moon in Capricorn. 6:18 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the moon is going to directly oppose the sun, both at this 29 critical karmic degree. The moon is in Capricorn energy. The sun is in Cancer energy. Of course, they share the axis and the zodiac wheel of safety, security, and stability. There is a new foundation coming into form. Where it is that we're coming from, where it is that we would like to go. Again, I'm going to recommend that you listen to the astro forecast, that you download the moon guide, and really get in alignment with these particular energies. Heads up, special notice here, once we reach this peak potency, things are starting to dissipate. The energy gets much better after the moon actually hits its peak potency. Now, 7:27 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the moon in Capricorn energy in the final minutes of the 29th degree is going to sextile beautiful interaction with Neptune, who is retrograde in his place of power in Pisces energy at the 29th degree. So this is a little bit of a refresher, a little bit of a renewal in our soul, in our spirit. We're gaining a little bit of insight. We're gaining a little bit of clarity on the goal, on the vision, on the dream that we now are anxiously trying to pursue. It is a beautiful vibe to kind of say goodbye to the moon in Capricorn, because it's at this particular point in time that the moon goes void of course. 7:44 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, we're locking into that Aquarian energy. About an hour later, maybe even 45 minutes later, let's say, the moon in Aquarius is going to make its very first interaction. It's a trine, it's a good one, with Mars. Mars is the god of war, ruling over our physical energy, our drive, our passion, our desires, even our anger, who's fresh in Gemini energy. We just shifted into this Gemini energy on the 20th. If you haven't listened to that astro forecast, I'm definitely going to recommend you do that as well. The moon and Mars, they're both in air energies. This is what gives us our trine. Our trine is a gentle nudge in the right direction. And with air energy, this is about information. This is about perspective. This is about ideas. And we're starting to get hyped up in a really fun kind of way, where we're semi-excited, semi-inspired to tackle a new path, tackle a new direction. Of course, Mars is rearing to go, has been stuck in that Taurus energy that we just broke out of for a very long time. So there's a lot of stagnancy there. And now in the Gemini energy, our minds are just working. We are trying to figure out what path, what direction, what avenue we want to take from here. The moon in Aquarius energy has us again acting as the observer to see things from a totally different perspective now that we're able to emotionally detach from the heaviness, from the weight that we have been sitting in for quite some time. The moon is then going to come up to bump into, team up with Pluto, because of course Pluto, the great transformer himself, is retrograde at a 0 degree here in the Aquarius energy. So this is a major shift in our mood, in our attitude, in our inner realm. This is a major shift in our, I'm going to say, perspective, in our ability to see the power, the control that we actually have in this present moment, especially over our inner realm of our thoughts and of our emotions. Now, things are going to get a little bit sticky early afternoon. The moon in Aquarius energy is going to semi-square, creating a little bit of tension and conflict with Saturn. Saturn is the Lord of Karma. He rules over roles, responsibilities, systems, structures, foundations. Saturn is retrograde in Pisces energy, but Saturn also rules over the Aquarius energy with Uranus. So this is a little bit of a Debbie Downer. This kind of knocks the wind out of our sails, if you will. Because we're starting to see where it is that we have a true responsibility. We have a true connection, a true responsibility for the outcome of our lives. If we don't like our physical realms, it's up to us to change it. If we don't like the way that our lives are going, we have the power to change it. But we have to get real and raw and vulnerable with ourselves in order to actually take accountability and responsibility for how our lives are going. Saturn in this Pisces energy is really helping us to kind of kick the limiting old belief system to the curb, really set our sights on the new foundation that we need to build in order to house the goals, the visions, the dreams that are suddenly becoming a little bit more clear. Venus, the goddess of love, beauty, worth, pleasure, and money in the heart and soul of the zodiac in this Leo energy, is going to sextile beautiful interaction with Jupiter. Jupiter is the planet of growth, expansion, beliefs, abundance, and blessings. He's in this Gemini energy. We love fire and air energy working together because this is how creative solutions come to be. This is how we shift our perspective, if you will, and we gain a different perspective of our lives. Now, this is about our own personal freedom. It's about what it is that we actually want for ourselves, what we envision would make us happy, bring a sense of joy and pleasure to our lives, especially where relationships are concerned. We definitely have an overall excitement, an inspiration, if you will, to want to do better, to want to be better. We're starting to kind of understand that yes, the hardships that we're going through, they're not fun, but they're essential for our growth. They're essential for our evolution in finding our true selves. And so this is going to be a beautiful energy for us to tap into. It's a beautiful mood. It's a beautiful attitude. We are looking at life through the most positive of lenses at this particular point in time. And it just kind of encourages us to loosen up a bit, to throw caution to the wind, and to start having a little bit more fun. So, in true energetic fashion, just when we're feeling good, there has to be a little bit of a Debbie Downer type of energy. Mercury, ruler of the mental plane, ruler of information, communication, how it is that we express ourselves in this Leo energy, going to get into the boxing ring and square off with Uranus in Taurus energy. So Uranus rules over the higher octave of our intellect, connecting us to the higher dimensions of intelligence, if you will. Mercury rules over the lower level of our intellect, very connected to our ego programming, because we bring in information and data from our materialistic realm, from our environment, and that is how we formulate our perspective, our understanding, our thoughts, our ideas. Uranus, on the other hand, we have to kind of see the forest past the trees, if you will. We have to understand that there's a greater, grander plan taking place here that may not be shown to us in our physical realms. So there's a clash of our headspace. There's a clash of our heart space right now. This square creates tension and conflict because we're being illuminated to where it is that we're going through major growing pains. And so, of course, it doesn't feel good. It is going to add a little bit of anxiety to our realm. It is going to make us feel a little bit on edge. There is a high probability that some shocking news, some shocking information, some, let's call it, wild details just come out of the woodwork. I say that because Uranus does have the ability to kind of bring forth some curveballs, if you will. But this is definitely going to put a lot of pressure on our headspace. It kind of puts us in a gridlock situation with our thoughts, with our ideas, with our patterns of thinking, with our conversations. And so we might be a little bit overstimulated. We're definitely, you know, still in the full moon energy, so there's that. But there could also be some downloads, some glimmers, some flashes of insight, some clarity coming at us, some new ideas that suddenly come out of nowhere. We may be very confused about it at this present time, but it's definitely planting the seed, if you will, for further expansion on these ideas, on these visions, on these goals, and on these dreams. We don't sit in that funk for too long. We do have the moon in Aquarius energy, sextiling, beautiful interaction with that North Node in Aries energy. So again, we have air and fire really helping us to see the vision for the future, the path, the goal, the dream that we wish to be walking. We're able to act as the observer, see where it is that we have the huge opportunity for growth, for expansion in our physical realms. The sun in Cancer energy, the final degrees, mind you, trines beautiful interaction with Neptune at the final degrees of the Pisces energy. Of course, Neptune is retrograde, so we have to deal with life as it is, not for the way that we wished it would be. But this is still water on water action, and we love this. First of all, this is going to shine a bright light on where it is that we're kind of renewing our soul and our spirit, where there's a renewal of hopes, of wishes, of dreams. This is a beautiful interaction for us to kind of see where it is that we have to be a little bit more tolerant of the situations, of the circumstances that aren't fun, that don't feel good, but understand from a spiritual perspective that they're helping us to align with our higher selves. This adds a little bit of a gentleness to the day. It kind of turns the volume up on our intuition, if you will, and it just kind of reassures us that we're not alone in this. We have help, we have support, we have a new foundation that we're building, not only within ourselves, but that the universe is providing for us as well. So the last thing that we have going on here today is Mars, the god of war, ruling over our physical energy, our drive, our passion, our desires, even our anger, trining beautiful interaction with Pluto, the great transformer himself, retrograde in Aquarius energy. So this is air on air action. This is going to put us in a new mood, in a new attitude, to be a little bit more positive, a little bit more optimistic, a little bit more accepting of our circumstances. We're trying to make the best of things. We're trying to be a little bit in a better mood, a better attitude about it. We're also starting to pluck out the silver linings on where it is that we are bossing up, where we're gifted an opportunity to kind of be our best selves, align with a new power, tap into a new control, especially over our thoughts, over our emotions, and our ability to really kind of micromanage our physical realm to help us align with a new path, a new direction, where new passions and desires are actually starting to percolate. This is a great energy for us to kind of see where it is that we're more motivated, more determined now than ever. We have a very strong sense of purpose taking over. It's almost like we don't have all the answers, but we know we're being called towards something very important for this karmic chapter. And so this is a beautiful energy for us. It is definitely a great way to end the day, and it is a great mood and attitude for us to be adopting under this full moon in Capricorn.